this is what a real rotameter looks like. In my notes, you would have noticed that I have very triangular looking things. So starting at the bottom, it's very pointy, and then it goes out as we go to the top. That is done for effect, just to show you that there is a slight increase in diameter at the top, but in reality, you can't really see it. And it could be that the inner diameter is fatter than the outer diameter, but we're not seeing it in here. This is a broken rotameter, so this one doesn't work. I was given it somewhere along the line, so you'll see the markings here. I'm not 100% sure what these are. We can guess what units those are. But inside, you will see there is the float. So as we've said in the notes and in class, when we have this upright, water will flow through the bottom, push this float up to the top, and then depending on where the forces balance, we will then read off the marking, wherever this might be. So let's just have it down there. So say the top is over there, we'll read the mark off there, and that's as simple as it gets. So in reality, all those calculations that we do in the notes, you'll never really have to use them in practice. The one thing that you will have to take into account, though, is the type of fluid flowing through here. So we'll get conversion charts for densities or temperature corrections and various other correction charts. But other than that, it's as simple as that. A tube, read off the flow rate, and you're done.